Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video we are going to learn about the optimal page replacement algorithm from the operating systems. So here we are going to replace the page that will not be used for the longest period of time. Okay, so we can't read the future here. Okay, so the drawback is we can't read the future. So in the optimal algorithm we are going to replace the page which is not used for the longest period of time. So in the case of FIFO we have seen that so the oldest page frame is replaced here. That means we are checking in the past, but in the case of the algorithm we are going to check the future of the, we are going to reference the upcoming pages here, right? But in the case of the FIFO algorithm we are going to check the oldest frames in that has come, that has entered the main memory in the past. Okay, so in the optimal it is going to read the future. Okay, but in the case of LRU algorithm it is going to, as well as it is going to check the oldest frames, and also it is going to count the, so based on the recently used frames we are going to replace the memory frames. Okay, so it is used for measuring how well your algorithm performs, and the optimal algorithm is the only algorithm that gives the less amount of page faults here. So we are going to implement the optimal page replacement algorithm with the given example. So we are having the reference string here, so the number of pages given here, and with the multiple number of frames. So we are taking 3 frames here for the reference string. So first of all, so we are going to note the first 3 frames as it is. So similar to the FIFO algorithm. So first we are going to load the page 7. So since the page 7 is not there in the main memory, so it is going to give a page fault here, right? And then we are going to load the 0th frame in the main memory. Since the 0 is not there in the main memory, and the first time we are loading the 0 here, it gives a page fault. Okay, so the next one is the 7, 0 and 1, right? So we are going to load the frame, the page 1 to the frame. Since the 1 is not available in the main memory, so it is going to give a page fault. Okay, so next, we have to load the page 2 here. So where we are going to place the page 2 in the main memory? Okay, so we are going to refer the future here. Okay, so in the given frame 7, 0 and 1, so in future, so 0 is used here, and then 1 is, so 1 is not used here, right? So 0 is the reference in the next string. So we are going to, we have to eliminate in the 7 and 1. Okay, so in the 7 and 1 we are going to eliminate the value 7. Based on the FIFO algorithm we are going to eliminate the value 7 here. Okay, and we are going to replace the 2. So we are going to replace the value 2 here in the place of 7. So we are going to replace the value 2 here in the place of 7. It gives a page fault since it is not available in the main memory. So 2, 0, 1. So there is a page fault. So next we are going to load the page 0 as it is to the main memory. Sorry, 0 is already there in the main memory. So there is no page fault in this case. So next one is a 3. So we have to load the string 3 here. We have to load the page 3 to the main memory. So how we are going to load here? So here the 2 is the 201, so we have to replace one of the frame. Okay, so here 0 is used here, and then 2 is used, and 1 is not we are not going to use the 1 in the future, right? So that's why we are going to replace the value 3 in the place of 1. So 2, 0, 3. Okay, so it gives a page fault, right? Since we are loading the value which is not available in the main memory, it gives a page fault. So next, so 0 is already there in the main memory. So there is no page fault. We are going to note down as it is here. Okay, so next 4. So we have to load the page 4 here. So already 203 are available. So in which place we have to load the page 4? Okay, so we can refer here. So 2 is, we are going to refer the 2 in the future, and the 3 in the future, and 0 in the future. Okay, so here we are going to first refer the 2 and then 3, right? So at last we are going to refer the 0. So that's why in the play, so we are going to give the more priority for 2 and 3, right? So we are going to use the page 2 and 3, so then the 0. So we are going to replace the page 4 in the place of the 0. Okay, so 2 and 3. Okay, so it gives a page fault here. The page 4 gives a page fault. Okay, so next one. So 2 is already there in the main memory, so there is no page fault. And then so 3 is also available in the, so 3 is also available in the main memory. So that's why there is no page fault here. We are going to note down as it is. Okay. And then 0. So we have to replace the 0 here. Okay. So here, so we are going to use the 3 in the next reference and then 2 in the last reference. So we have to replace the 0 in the place of 4. So 2. 0 and 3. So there is a page fault here. 0 is a page fault. So we are having the page fault here. Okay, so next, so since the 3 is already available in the main memory, there is no page fault, right? So next one is 0. So 0 is also there in the main memory, so there is no page fault here. So 3 is also available in the main memory, so there is no page fault. And 2 is also available in the main memory, so there is no page fault. Okay, so if you count here, we are having totally, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So we are having totally 7 page faults here. So totally. Okay, so there is 7 page faults here. So here the hit ratio is higher. It gives a hit, right? Page hit. So wherever there is no page fault, so there is a page hit here. So page hit. Okay. And this one also there is a page hit. So here also 2 is already there in the main memory, so it gives a page hit, right? So here 3 is also there in the main memory, so it gives a page hit. So here the 0 has a page fault. So here 3 is already available in the main memory, it gives a page hit. Okay, so 0 is there in the main memory, so it gives a page hit. So wherever there is no page fault, there is a page hit. Okay, so if you calculate the number of page hits, then so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So we are having the 8 page hits and only 7 page faults. So that's why the optimal page replacement algorithm works very efficiently compared to the remaining algorithms. But the only drawback here is we can't predict the future, right? So here the 7 is optimal for this example. So the optimal is the 7. Okay. So it is used for measuring how well the algorithm works. To know the performance of the algorithm, this algorithm is used. Okay. So this is about the optimal algorithm. And thanks for watching my video. Thank you.